Hosanna in the highest. Toward the close of Jesus' ministry, he came to Bethany, to the home of Lazarus, Martha, and Mary, the same Lazarus whom he had awakened from the sleep of death. Mary chose this opportunity to anoint the Master's feet with precious ointment, which he declared was an anointing for his burial. The next day he sent for an ass and rode thereon into Jerusalem after the manner of Israel's king. When Jesus came in sight of Jerusalem, he wept over the city, exclaiming, O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, which killest the prophets and stonest them that are sent unto thee, how often would I have gathered thy children as a hen gathereth her brood under her wings, but ye would not. Now I say unto you, your house is left unto you desolate. Ye shall see me no more until that day of Messiah's glory, when ye shall say, Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Meantime, the kingdom is not abandoned, merely delayed. Messiah's bride will be only partly Jewish. Israel hath not obtained the coveted chief favor, but the elect obtained it. The multitude caught the spirit of the occasion that Jesus was the promised king and hailed him as Messiah. They scattered clothing and palm branches before him, implying that the best of earth was not too good for one so great. Meantime, they shouted, Hosanna to the Son of David, the long-promised Messiah of David's line. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of Jehovah. The Pharisees, who did not believe, thought the procedure sacrilegious and told Jesus to stop the shouting. Jesus replied that the prophet Zechariah said, Shout, and therefore there must be a shout. If they should hold their peace, the very stones would cry out. God had declared it. There must be a shout. The prophecy must be fulfilled. Cleansing the temple of money changers and merchants followed our Lord's triumphal entry into the city.